climate change and international development are intrinsically linked. The floods, fires, and droughts caused by rising global temperatures lead to massive displacement, food and health crises, and economic distress. Methane reduction in the energy sector is a fast, actionable, and affordable way to help save millions of lives and shave 0.2 degrees Celsius from the global temperature, working toward the 1.5 degree limit. Methane is one of the worst contributors to global warming, and nearly 40% of emissions from human activity come from the energy sector, with many super-emitters located in developing countries. 7.5% of global gas is currently wasted through burning or venting. What if, instead, wasted gas was captured and used or sold? We could slow global warming, eliminate a threat to human health and food security, increase energy access, and help generate tens of billions of dollars per year for national economies. Here's how it can work. Drawing on the IMF's tax policy guidance, governments tax companies for estimated methane emissions, focusing on super-emitters. Governments track emissions independently via satellite, increasing accountability. Companies are incentivized to use gas capture and monetization technologies. Companies earn rebates for verified emissions reduction, and the world is a cooler, cleaner, safer place. 150 countries have endorsed the 2021 Global Methane Pledge to reduce methane emissions by 30% by 2030. Now is the time for the IMF and other financial institutions to help country governments put those pledges into practice.